Okay, in this video I just want to go through a few examples on how to multiply complex numbers, and hopefully by the end you will have a good grasp of this concept. So in the first example, suppose I have one complex number z1 is equal to 2 plus 3i and another z2 is equal to 1 plus 5i, and I want to find the product of z1 times z2. Well, the multiplication of complex numbers follows the exact same process as the distributive law of algebra. So if I write z1 times z2 is equal to 2 plus 3i multiplied by 1 plus 5i, I would distribute this exactly the same way as I would with algebra. So my high school math teacher liked to call this the moon method, because the lines that I'm drawing in red somewhat resemble a crescent-shaped moon, if you can use your imagination. So if we carry out the process, we will get 2 times 1 plus 2 times 5i plus 3i times 1 plus 3i times 5i. And then to simplify, I get 2 plus 10i plus 3i, and then plus, so 3 times 5 is 15, and then I times I is equal to I squared. And then if I simplify further, I get 2 plus 13i, and then plus 15 times I squared. Now I squared is equal to negative 1, because the square root of negative 1 squared is equal to negative 1. So so this effectively becomes negative 13 plus 13i. Okay, for the second example, this is quite a special case, because the second term here is what we call the complex conjugate of the first term. And as you'll see, whenever we multiply a complex number by its conjugate, we will get a real number. And remember, in algebra, whenever we have a plus b times a minus b, we get a squared minus b squared as the result. And it's the same principle here, so taking this shortcut, I should get 2 squared minus 3i squared, and 2 squared is equal to 4, minus 3 squared is 9, and then I squared, and we get 4 minus 9, well, I squared is equal to negative 1 again, so effectively we have 4 plus 9, which is equal to 13. And in the third instance, we can follow the laws of binomial expansion, so whenever we have a plus b squared, we end up with a squared plus 2ab plus b squared. So if we follow this formula, we have 3 squared plus 2 times 3 times I, negative I, that is, because we have a minus I, and then plus negative I squared. Okay, so 3 squared is equal to 9, then minus 2 times 3 is equal to 6, and the I stays, and then plus negative 1 squared is equal to positive 1, and then we have I squared. So we have 9 minus 6i plus negative 1, because I squared is equal to negative 1, and we end up with 8 minus 6i. So here are three common examples of multiplication of complex numbers. If you have found this video useful, please give me a like and subscribe to my channel. And as always, please feel free to ask me any math question by commenting below. Best of luck with your math studies, and I'll see you next time.